What's going on YouTube? Clark Bishop here. Today is a different type of day. Today is a day about giving. Something we all should be doing more on a regular, because giving is just, it shows people that you care about them. And today I got a couple items on this list that's very, very inexpensive. They're under $30, and thought about you guys and thought about your family. They might like you a little bit more if you get them a gift, especially your photographers, cinematographers, videographers, camera guys, photo guys, whatever you want to call us. We like gifts too, and here are some of the most inexpensive gifts I believe every photographer or cinematographer should have in their kit. My first gift that's on this list is the cleaning kit. It comes in at a whopping $8.46. It's basically like the little air squeegee that you can blow into your lens sensor. I don't even have one. I still be blowing into my lens the old-fashioned way. I just believe it's a good gift for anybody that works with cameras, because you may be in certain situations where it's dust or little speckles get on your lens, you just need to get it out. Instead of you trying to use your t-shirt or blow it out, you can use this. It's the best and it's the safest way. So that's gift number one. Gift number two is a triangular prism. Prisms are cool because they change the dynamic of your shot. It just makes an effect, an in-camera effect, that's different than anybody else's shot. And you can use them in so many different ways. You can like put them on your lens, you can put them two on your lens. You can do so much with these. And this prism comes in at a whopping $10.99. It's very cheap, very inexpensive, and I don't have one, but I always wanted to get one just to test it out, just to see the different looks I could get. I see people using the music videos all the time. They can get different flares and just different effects that you wouldn't get trying to do it in post-production. Doing it in pre-production, just a whole, because it works with the sun and the different elements that you're in already, so it's just going to provide a new look and a look that nobody else has had, so a triangle prism. My third one is kind of the same, but it's in the ball form. It's a crystal ball. I know like a couple years ago, I used to see these crystal balls and photographers taking pictures in the most exotic places, and they look real cool. And I just want a crystal ball just to like have it and play with. It looks cool, like just to have around, or a different prop that would be like in the back of your videos. Like now, crystal balls are cool, very cheap. It's a pack of three. Comes in at $26.99. All these 99s. It's real dope, man. It's three of them. You get like three different sizes, so if you like balls, I didn't mean to go there, but if you like balls, crystal balls, it's pretty cool. So that's number three. Number four is a 5-in-1. 5-in-1s are real cool because you can always use reflector or diffuser or a negative field to make your videos or photos a little bit more dynamic. It softens the light on your subject, it reflects light back if you need more light, and the negative kills light to make a more dramatic effect. 5-in-1s are great. This is a 37x41. It comes in at a whopping $24.99. And this is a great gift for any photographer or cinematographer, especially if they don't have one. This one is kind of smaller. I got a big circle one, and so I always don't like to just bust it out because it's like always in the way. This one's a nice size. It could like control someone's face, especially if you're trying to get portraits or you're just trying to do video, small video setups like this one. $24.99, 5-in-1 filter. My last one is an SD card. Everyone can use an extra SD card, especially if it's a really good one. My favorite are the Lexar professional cards. I actually got one in my other camera. I've been using Lexars for quite some years now, and I'm telling you, they're really good. They're really good. Mine is 128 gigabytes, and it has and they can read up to 150 megabytes per second. If you're shooting a lot of slow-mo or a lot of high-quality 4K, your cinematographer or photographer will like you a lot, because these SD cards can get expensive, but lucky for you, I found one that's only 1987, sounds like a year, and it's 64 gigs, and it reads at 250 megabytes per second, so it's even faster than the one I got right now. I might go buy this right now just because it's nice. So those are five gifts I believe every cinema photographer or photographer should have in a kit. It's around the holidays. Go look out for your photographer friend. Go get these gifts for them. Appreciate you guys for watching my video. You can leave this a like, share this to people who may seem interested. I appreciate that. And subscribe to my channel. I appreciate you guys. It's all about giving, so give me a subscribe, and I appreciate that. And I'll see you guys in the next video.